Hello everyone, welcome to the next lecture on the MATLAB programming. Today we will discuss about the MATLAB code of Runge-Kutta 4th order method. Although it is an inbuilt code as a RK45 in the MATLAB programming, but always encouraged to do itself a MATLAB programming so that you may understand how you can do the program. So we will discuss the step-by-step explanation for this ordinary differential equation. Myself, Dr. Garg, working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute, India. You can contact me, either of my email IDs are there, else simply follow this channel name Dr. Harish Garg, where you can find the various videos related to the MATLAB programming. What is the objective of this very short video is that we will try to construct the MATLAB code for this differential equation, that is the first order differential equation, by using Runge-Kutta method. So we will try to generalize this MATLAB code where you can change the value of the f of x, y. You can change the value of the y0, x0 as per your own convenience. So you can change this value as per your own desire. Then the MATLAB code will be running there. So in our last lectures, we have seen how we can define the MATLAB code of the Euler's modified and so on. And in this lecture, we will see the Runge-Kutta methods are there. What is the brief theory behind this Runge-Kutta method is that we will try to update the positions from the x0, y0 to the x1, y1, where the positions are updated by x plus h, where h is called as the step size, and the y coordinates are updated with the help of y plus k, where k is nothing but weighted average of the ki's. How you can find the value of the ki's? We can use this, these expressions are there. Based on this, we have solved in our last lecture related to the Runge-Kutta, there is a theory lecture, we have solved this problem. Now in this lecture, we will try to construct the MATLAB code for this problem so that it can match with your results. So we know that if based on this lecture, which is available in my description part, the solution, the final answer of this problem is here. The same way we can try to solve, we will try to find the value of k1, k2, k3, k4. And then we will try to find the value of k, and hence we will get this value. So in order to solve this in the MATLAB, we will see how we can solve it in the MATLAB window. So in order to start the MATLAB code, we will try to write firstly the format short. Why there is a need of the format short? I think all of you know that. If you look about this, if I write here as say 1/5, you can see the decimals are results is up to the 4 decimal places. If you write here as a 10/7, you can see the result is only up to the 4 decimal places. But if you write here as a format long, then you can write as a 10/7, you can see the result are up to the 16 decimal places are there. So that's why that's depending upon you whether you want to use the format short or the format long. You have to clear all these store variable, whatever the variable you have stored, and the CLC is the most important command, that is you have to use the clear the screen like CLC. That is all the variables are screen is cleared. Now in order to define this MATLAB code of this Runge-Kutta method, what you can do is the first thing is that you have to define the function and then initialize the parameter. What is the function is, if you try to compare your function with the help of this, make sure that your the coefficient of dy by dx is 1. So if you compare them, what is the value of the f of xy is, that is x y raised to power 1/3. So this part you have to write in here. So make sure that the function which are dependent on the x and y, so I have written at the rate x and y. So x dot of this, that is x into y. So what is the meaning of that? If I write here as of the this, you can see this. So what is the value of the f1, 2? You can see if you want to compute the value of f1, 2, it will be 1 2 raised to power 1/3. Or what is the value of the f2, 1? So x is my 2, 1 raised to power 1/3 is nothing but 2. So if I try to write here, this is the value of the f1/2, this is the value of the f2/1. You can write even either as a larger value of this, say here, that is x is my -45, y is 17,600. You will get this answer. So this is the meaning of this function, that's a generalization are there. So whatever the function you have, if you want to solve this problem, like of y minus x, provided y of 0 is say 3. So what you can do is you have to replace this function, you have to replace this line with the y minus of x. Now you have to input the parameters. Either you can take the users, or else you can take, since initial value is 1, so you can simply write here as a x is 1. Else you can take from the users, like here if I write here as input, enter the initial x. So you can see if I press the enter, they will ask you enter the value of the x. So if I say x is my 1, okay, otherwise you can also change them. I can write here as a 2 and so on. If you don't want to change, you can write here as x is 1. Similarly, I can input the value of the y also. Again, you can write here either as a y is, what is the value of the initial y is 1. But I always encourage to do this user inputs are there. Next, what is the step size are there? You can see I target is 1.1, my 1. So you can put up the input as step size. After that, you have to put the target value. So since in this particular example, my target value is 1.1. So I can put the inputs, enter the x at which y is required. Once you are defining the all these input parameter, now we can define the RK fourth order method. What is the rule for the fourth order method is we have to define these KIs are there. So we can start with a loop while x minus x is y, this number is written here. So you can see some, you can also write this, sometime you can also write x minus x is greater than equal to 0, or also you can write like here. But sometime it may take a problem, like here, if I firstly clear the screen. So if I write here as x as a 1.4, small x again as a 1.4. So what is the difference between them? It must be 0, but you can see the difference is not be a 0. It's a very small number. Some, because it's safe internal memories are there. That's whenever the program will run again and again times, so it will save these values are there. This e raised to power minus 16 means 10 raised to power minus 16. So it means this condition will violate when you do this one. So it will terminate one step before that. So that's why I have taken this number, that is 10 raised to power any of the number which are smaller than, look at that, my number is 0. So I take any of the number which are smaller than of this. So, or you can also take as 10 raised to power minus 17, or you can take 10 raised to power minus 9 as per your demand out there. So once you are writing here, then we will try to write a k, k1 and so on. So we can firstly print the values, value of the y at x is, what is the meaning of the 0.2f? 0.2 means that is print the value 2 decimal places. So if I write here as a 0.2 means that is a 2 decimal places. If you write as a 0.4, this 4 means that is a 4 decimal places are there. And if you simply write here as a percentage f, it will display up to the whether you use the format short or the format long accordingly. Once you will print these values are there, now we can write this line. Firstly, k1, that is h into f, function is written as f. Input value, I have taken x and y. Why? You can see that what is the input are there, x and y. Capital X is my target. So that's why capital X minus of the small x are there. So I can write here as a x into y. Second, you can write here as a k2, h, f of x plus h by 2, comma, y plus k1, which is stored in the form of the k1 divided by 2. Similarly, you can write here as a k3, h, f, x plus this. Similarly, you can write here as a k4. Once you are writing all these ki's are there, then your target is to write the k. You can simply write k as k1 plus 2 times k2 plus 2 times k3 plus k4 divided by 6. After finding the value of k, you have to write here as a y is y plus k. Now since I have used here as a x and y, so I can update the value of the x as x plus h, update the x. Similarly, you can update the value of y as y plus k. And that's once it will be running, once it will update, until they will check whether whatever the x is my 1.1. If it is satisfied this condition, it will be run again and again. And that's a simple end of this MATLAB code. You can see I can run this if I clear this screen out here, and if I show you this is the file, I can, whatever the function you have taken, if you have used this, you can use this one. Otherwise you can use y minus x as per on your choice. So you can see whatever I have discussed here, I have written in this line. Now if I run this file, So you can see they will ask you the initial value of the x. So in this particular example, what is the initial value of x is 1. So I can take as a 1. Enter the initial value of y is again 1. Why? You can see this is 1. What is the step size is? You have to start from the 1 to the 1.1. So I can take as say 0.1. What is the required target is? I want to be a 1.1. So I can see as a 1.1. So you can see this is the result up to the two decimal places. The final answer is here. Also, if you want to run again, if I say 1.1 and if I want to calculate instead of 1.1, I want to calculate at a 1.5. So what you can do is you can simply replace this value as a 1.5. Press the enter, you can get the value of 1 is here. Add the 1.1, this is the answer. Add the 1.2, this answer, 1.3 and so on. Also, if you want to solve like this differential equation, like say y square minus x, provided y of 0 is my 1, and you want to compute the values at 0.9 with the step size of 0.3. So what you can do is you have to simply replace this function. You can see I can comment this one, and I have to define this function as y square minus of x. That rest is nothing is changed, you have to write. And then once you will run this file, you can see now you have to provide the information. Input value is my 0, y is my 1, so you have to put 0, 1. What is the step size is my 0.3, target is 0.9, so you have to put 0.3, target is 0.9. You have to compute with the help of this is the required answer. So this is a generalized MATLAB code of this. You have to simply replace, remember that you have to simply replace this objective function according to your own target. So I hope you can enjoy this session too. If you want to find the another MATLAB code like Simpson 1/3, this Euler method, modified Euler method and many more, you can watch this playlist, numerical analysis under the channel in this Gauss Seidel and many more. So you can find all this video under the channel, this YouTube channel link. Thank you very much. Best of luck, students. Happy learning.